It's time for the Giz Wiz with man's maddest writer, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1599, recorded December 1st, 2016. Engrave Danger! This episode of the Giz Wiz, it's December, so Christmas or holidays, whatever you do, is in the air. We get to find out what my crappy corner is this month, and Dick has some things from CES 2017. All next on the Giz Wiz!
It's the same old show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
under pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, growing blue and LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Time for the Giz Wiz, and here he is, the encyclopedia of gadgets, Dick DeBartolo. How you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing super, and you, sir?
I'm doing as super as well. I'm doing
good,
super,
good,
super.
Good.
It's been a fun week. We're finally in December.
December, the tree is up. Can you see it behind me?
Oh, look at that. Oh, that's great.
My world famous fiber optics Christmas tree.
How long have you had that tree?
From the movie. Remember the movie I got this from? Anyway, they shot a movie down at the boat, and there's a detective, Colin Farrell, is on a boat, and in the background is what I owned back then, my houseboat, and it's supposed to be New Year's Eve, and he's all alone, and they put this Christmas tree in my window, and there's a big champagne party going on my boat, which turned out to be water. The people,
listen, it's just bubbly water.
Yes,
okay?
Exactly.
Don't worry.
And they kept saying, they were shooting it at 4 a.m, so I paid somebody to go down there and just watch my boat and be on the boat. And they said, no, not only was it not champagne, it was water. And every time they would start the scene over, they all had to pour it back into the champagne bottle.
Ew. Gross. So anyway, you get backwash from like 20 different actors.
No. Yes. Isn't that awful?
Gross.
Because it's very hard to get fresh water down there in the winter because they shut all the plumbing off.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So anyway,
when the shoot was over, one of the people from the production called and said, "We'll come down tomorrow and clean your boat up if there's anything you want." They said, "We are trashing everything that's on your boat."
So, you're like, "Give me the tree."
I said, "Can I take the fiber optic tree?" They said, "Yeah, we're just going to throw it out."
That is so funny.
Pride and Glory. Thank you,
Pride Steve and Rex. Glory is the name of the movie. That reminds me of a story Brushwood told me, because I've always shot Scam School with him, and he did an episode with National Geographic, and they had a scene in a bar, which is, you know, interesting from a perspective of, at Scam School, we shot at bars all the time. I mean, that was the only location that we shot at isn't
his a lot of his scams.
Oh yeah, they're
ways
bar
to
tricks.
Get free drinks.
Exactly. Totally.
Yeah,
totally.
Okay. Yeah,
and
right.
So, you know, he's super used to that. And every time we go to a bar, we open up a tab. The people who are on the show get free drinks. It's great. They were like, "Don't worry. All of the drinks, everyone behind you is a paid extra. And all of the drinks are non-alcoholic." And he's like, "What? Are you kidding me?" Like, you know, we're just so used to going in guerrilla internet style where the people in the background are too loud because, of course, they're not paid extras or just happen to be at this bar that we're at.
Oh, that's very funny.
It was very, very, very funny to see the difference between Hollywood and the internet.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, they were drinking water in the background. Okay, with that, let's jump into some gadgets.
Okay,
shall
we will. This is three more gadgets from CES 2017. And I think I mentioned last week, they hold an event in New York City, CES does, where they hand out the awards so that people who win awards can make the most of it at CES, the big event in Vegas. So we know what's going to happen. So we're going to start out with a 3D printer. And I hope I got this in the right order. What's your first video?
I have the UCAM.
Okay, the UCAM. My pages came out of the printer backwards. Okay, this is a very fun gadget, and the woman explains it very clearly. So let's watch the video.
Dick DeBartolo, man's maddest writer. Oh, my lips went away. Oh, they're back. Oh, how do you like my eyes? Yeah, it's Dick DeBartolo, man's maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz. One take theater here at gizwiz.tv. This is really kind of a make amazing. It's called the UCAM makeup, and we're going to find out about it here from, I've forgotten your name already, from Lindsay. So Lindsay, are you selling the mirror, or what are we doing?
Yeah, so it's a free download on your phone. There's 350 million global downloads of the app, so anybody can download it for free. And then we work with different beauty brands, so you can try on actual products directly from the app. We also work with different publications to do campaigns, like trying on runway looks from New York Fashion Week or red carpet looks.
You know, as we talk, can we take a picture of you trying something on?
Oh. So this is our live cam mode, so you literally can just browse through different looks that we featured over time and try them on. You can see my lips, eyes, contours, all changing. If you want, you can actually, we can customize the look. So we say we kind of like this, but I maybe want to change the lip. I'm going to take a selfie. Not a good one, but
that is really great.
And then I can go in and try on different lip colors from different brands. So we work with different brands. You can see here. So we can try on a Laura Geller lip gloss. And then if I'm not really sure what people say about this lip gloss, I can go in and read reviews. I can see here that 230,000 people have tried on this lip gloss, and I can actually purchase it through the app as well. You can do everything from change your eye color, whiten your teeth, under eye bags. We can put on some green eyes for fun, or blue eyes.
Contact lenses.
And then you can actually do how intense you want to make your eyes, but that's definitely not what my eyes look like, but I wish. And let's see, if we're like, we want to put in some hair accessories here. You can just kind of tap.
This is really amazing. You can, instead of getting dressed to go out, you can just dress yourself at home and send a photo and say, oh, I felt ill, but this is what I looked like just before I became ill.
And now you can actually add sunglasses. We worked with Marie Claire to feature their best sunglasses of the summer. So you can shop and try on sunglasses all through the app as well. You can change your hair color, hair styles, earrings, really like...
So is it Android and iOS?
Yep, it's free download on...
And the,
what was that?
Do they tell you what products to use to achieve
Yes, that's rolling out now, where after you can click this button here so where it says details, and it will open up and show you what you have used. And if there are products that are purchasable through the app that you tried on, it will give you that option here as well. But you can see this is showing you, you know, all the different stuff that I put on at the time. And, you know, incorporated into all of this, there's how-tos and beauty inspo. It's kind of a whole
beauty journey. Behind this is an iPad. What are we looking at?
An iPad Pro in this special light that our company creates. But this, you can do this on your phone. I use it on my regular iPhone.
Okay. Can you do it on a regular computer, too?
There is actually a new product called Makeup Director, which is kind of this, but on a computer.
On a computer.
And a little bit dialed up. It's really for makeup artists to be able to, like, edit and try things from, like, a software perspective on their computer.
And the name of the app you should look for is?
UCAM Makeup.
UCAM. I'm sorry. UCAM Makeup.
Yeah.
This is really, really neat. Thanks so much. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz One Take Theater, Ordinary Face, here at gizwiz.tv. Bye.
I wonder when they're going to be able to add my hair onto anybody.
I know.
Anyone can try the OMG Chad. Oh,
yeah,
man.
Several people said I should have put hair on me.
Exactly.
I guess they don't have men's hair.
Yeah, possibly. Yeah. Now, it's so funny because we have the Giz Wiz chat, and then I have my Twitch chat, and my Twitch chat's demographics actually skew female. And my Twitch chat I'm seeing downloading. Oh, interesting. Installing. Like, everyone is so excited about this because if
it's such a clever, you know.
It's such a clever idea.
Yes, because, you know, we always had things where you could add bandanas and stuff to photos that you had. But this is to actually see what you look like using real products.
Right.
And a lot of them available through the app, which is how they make their money. But the app works great, and the amount of varieties that the woman just showed me in that little demo, it seems like a very clever and useful idea.
Yeah, I mean, my chat's already critiquing it. It doesn't do foundation. Gosh darn it. Because, like, you know, I mean, if you really only have a few options if you want to test out makeup before you try it on, which is to go into the store and apply a little bit of it to yourself, and you come out looking like a clown. So, you know, the chat seems like this is a product that they would love to test out looks and then be directed to the products to buy to achieve those looks. So, yeah. Anyway, I think that's a very, very cool gadget, and a great way to to test out makeup. So, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, and guys can go there if they want to see what they look like.
In drag,
exactly.
It'd be great.
Okay, our next gadget is, we have to meet the guy first, and then you can tell your story about where you heard his name first. So let's go back to CES Unveiled 2017 and meet Yosef. DeBartolo, Mads Medist writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. We're evidently talking to the top guy. Did you invent this?
No, I didn't invent this, but I made it goddamn simple so everybody can build a printer and use a printer.
Okay, now this is the first under $1,000 3D four-color printer. Is that right?
Not four-color, actually four material.
You
can mix and match, like flexible, sturdy, and dissolvable, so you can make more intricate things.
Can we see some examples of what you've done?
Well, for example, this is full four colors. You can see that there's four materials in the one.
Is this out on the market now?
Well, the normal machine is selling for a couple months for $699. We just won the best printer of the year on Make Magazine, which is coming out in like a week. And the more four material, everybody who has the normal Mark II can actually buy a $249 upgrade and upgrade it themselves.
Oh, that is really great. Everybody that I know loves Make Magazine, and so this is very impressive. And are both these machines the same but doing different things, or is one of them the upgraded machine?
So this is the normal Mark II, okay. And the one on the right is the upgraded one. So we don't want to force anyone to buy a new machine if you have perfectly good machine. So we sell upgrade kits, and you can upgrade it yourself. I think it's a nice thing.
I think that's a great thing. And this is so amazing. What are we looking at here? And you printed this on one of these machines?
Yes, yes. It's printed in many pieces. It takes like 6 hours to print. It's a lot. But, you know, you don't have to sit behind next to the printer when it's printing. And then it's assembled. And you get more intricate stuff.
And then take a shot of the magazine cover there, too. So
it does look
Make Magazine. What's the cover date on that?
It's going to be published in like a week. So it's December and January 2017 issue.
Okay, great.
And take a look at this. Have you ever seen something this detailed printed on 3D printer?
Probably our camera can probably not even get that.
Wow.
Is it a little statue?
Buddha?
A Buddha?
Yeah, it's Buddha and Boba Fett from Star Wars remixed into one thing. It's called
Boba Fett Buddha.
Buddha Fett.
So everything on the table you guys printed yourself?
Yes, yes. Printed ourselves in Prague and brought it here for CES Unveiled New York.
Great. And the attachment and the upgrade is available when?
It is right now in pre-order, and it starts to ship in like 5 to 6 weeks. Right now, if you buy it, there's a long line.
Right.
Okay. For it to come on.
But Yeah, it starts shipping in a couple of weeks.
Okay. This is really great. Good luck, and we'll see you again at CES.
Thank you. See you
okay.
later.
Dick DeBartolo, Mazmet is right, and the Giz Wiz One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Also in 3D. This is all just printed. Bye.
So that's from Prussia Research. And you were mentioning, maybe I have heard of this guy before.
Yes.
And so where may I have heard of him before?
Didn't you say that there was a company called RipRap?
Or yes. Yes, I did. So RipRap was a 3D printer where the printer was made to print itself. And you would use a small amount of material that couldn't be 3D printed and then add all of the other pieces onto it. And
right. Well, somewhere in their website. Oh, are you, oh, there you go.
That's the RepRap wiki. Here's the Prussia research.
Oh, okay. Somehow those websites get interconnected. There must be a link between.
Oh, yeah. Look at that. Open source design. Joseph Prussia works with the RepRap community.
Oh, that's where I saw that name.
Very cool.
But Make Magazine, I'll just read one sentence from this. This is Make Magazine of this December and January 2017. It said that it has raised a bar for consumer 3D printing platforms. Using their test score, it got 36 points, which is more than any machine they have ever tested.
Wow.
And it won three different awards, and
yes.
It is really getting great reviews, and that you can use. And what I liked what he said is that they came out with this new option where you could use four different print materials, four different colors, and if you have the printer before it, it's an option that you can just add on to the printer that you bought. Now, someone in the chat room was saying it was expensive. But, boy, you know, when you add the four-way color and four material thing, it comes to about $1,000. I guess because the price of printers is going down, someone thinks that is expensive. But a few years ago, this would have been – and also it has a very large area for printing. You know, a lot of the stuff we saw around $500, you can only print something 6 inches by 6 inches. But this one has a rather large area for printing. And what you just talked about, the printer printing itself.
Yeah.
Yes. There's a little video. Why don't you run that video and
okay.
We can talk over it. It's a little one-minute video from, I guess they call it Prusa, P-R-U-S-A printing, is that they have what they call the print farm. And
so,
so the print farm are their i3 machines printing more of themselves. And each machine can make one of itself in 20 hours. So basically, one machine builds another machine in a day. And these machines run round the clock, 24/7, building more printers. And I already saw that they're falling behind on orders already for that new four-color, four-material option. So I guess they're going to have to make more printers. I guess if the space is big enough, every day you could add 24 more printers to the printing farm.
Yeah, it just gets exponentially larger.
Yes, yes.
Spend a day and then make double your amount of printers.
Yeah. So you know what?
Wonder, that's a lot of printers. Holy cow.
I wonder if you got four of your friends together, could you buy one of these and set it up and print printers for the other three and then divide the cost? I don't know.
Maybe. You'd have to know exactly how many how many things can't be 3D printed. You know, what circuit
yes.
boards, what LCD screens, what wires can't be 3D printed.
Right.
But,
And will they give that information out?
Yeah, I mean, who knows? He said, I mean, on the website it said open source, but I've also seen that, I need to dive in, do some research, because I've seen open source some stuff, but not everything. But looking at a few things. Oh my God, on their shop, I need.
And Beatmaster asked, I did not get the price of the materials to make the printer, so I don't know what it would cost to make a 3D printer.
Right, exactly. Open source design. I mean, it says it works with the RepRap community, but not the main creator works with the RepRap community. I'm not sure open it is.
Yeah, but you can it's PRUSA. What is their thing? Their website is, I think, 3D.
Yeah, Prush, or however you said it.
Prusha, I think
Prusha.
He said it.
PRUSA
3D.com.
Right.
And all the info is there. And there's a big blog and a ton of reviews.
So if you want it built and calibrated, it costs $900. And if you want it, I guess just the parts, the kit is $700. So very interesting.
Yeah.
And it feels like the market has just been flooded.
Yes.
With printers and at so many different price points and so many different, you know, things. It's hard to kind of know what's the best. And it seems like the thing that's been hard to tell is capability and the what they're showing right here is how fine of a print you can do, and it looks like you can do different presets to have a nicer print in a longer amount of time versus a shorter amount of time, but a more coarse and tough print. Very interesting. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, all the different materials that they work with. It just seems very fascinating to kind of see a printer kind of take a few things in a few different directions, and having four different print materials is a nice
at one time. It looks like it handles like 12 different print materials. Yeah, so Make Magazine, you can read about all the printers and why they thought this one was the best.
Perfect. Okay, next gadget.
Okay, our next gadget is all about germs and how to get rid of them.
I don't like
germs.
So
let's go back to CES 2017. Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz. One take theater here at gizwiz.tv. So we see a sign that says 99.99% eradication of germs within 60 seconds. I'm interested. And Desiree here is going to tell how we can be germ-free.
So this is Ellie, the first portable baby bottle sterilizer that sterilizes germs in just 60 seconds. 99.
So what, will you have clean germs? I hope it kills them, right?
It does. It does. So a baby bottle, essentially, if you're a new mom and let's say you're on the subway with baby and baby drops pacifier or bottle, no problem. Pick up the bottle, pop it in Ellie, done in 60 seconds.
You know, can I do other things like my phone and my toothbrush?
Of course, yeah. Anything that fits inside the portable sterilizer can be sterilized. Yeah, let's do it. I'm just trying to be gentle.
Oh, okay. Does that little shelf come out if you want?
No, so the shelf is actually, it stays there, but you can actually do two bottles. You can do more than one bottle at a time, or you can put the pacifier up here as well. Sophie the giraffe, any of those. So the idea is essentially that you've got that.
It's battery operated, or is it rechargeable battery, or what's the power source? Oh, we have to go to the men. The question of the day is, is it powered by rechargeable batteries or C batteries or D
batteries?
Chargeable battery, okay. USB charge.
Yep, right here. The charge lasts for 7 days. Takes about a half an hour to charge. with regular use about 7 days.
Okay, and do various items take various amount of times to get sanitized?
No, absolutely not. Anything you put in the chamber, 60 seconds, as long as it has line of sight to the UV light.
Okay, and the retail price of that guy?
$129.
And available?
On Indiegogo in a week. And on Indiegogo, we're offering a promotional introductory price of 40% off, which is about $78.
And you expect to ship it by?
April.
By April 2017. Okay, I like it. And the name of the product is just Ellie?
Ellie.
I like this. Dick DeBartolo, Man's Medist Writer, and the Giz Wiz. One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Just going to sanitize my teeth. Bye.
Don't look at the light, Dick. Don't look at the light. You'll sanitize your eyeballs right out of your head. very interesting.
Yeah. And you know, go to their website, because they had just started on Kickstarter. And when I looked about 3 days ago, they wanted 40,000. They were almost at 70,000.
It looks like they are currently at 71,000 of 40. So they have gone past their goal. They still have 23 days left in there.
Go. And what is the cheapest price that's left?
Looks like the 99 one, but travel sleeve 77 is sold out. It looks like $89 plus shipping is currently the cheapest available price.
Oh, okay.
And then $99 to get the ultimate gift package.
Yeah, and I was sort of surprised at the show that it seemed like they were only pitching it for baby stuff. And then when I got to and that's why I asked, and then I see on their website that,
cosmetics,
you know, it's
for
absolutely anything.
Right.
So what is your take on this? Is this something that you think you would buy?
I don't think I would for the current price point. But I think it is an interesting idea, especially if you are worried about... I mean, I've seen what babies do to things. They throw stuff on the ground, they pick it up and put it in their mouth.
Yeah,
so,
exactly. Exactly.
You know, I definitely feel like that is a good angle. By the way... this shelf, while it doesn't remove, it can flip down.
Yes, yes. I could see looking at it. I didn't want to break
it. There's some mechanism,
Right. But then I noticed, as you just did too, that it folds down so that two bottles can go in there side by side. And the fact that you can charge it once in a half hour and then have it work for 7 days.
Yeah, that's great.
I guess if you're a mom, and especially for... what you just said, that kids, it doesn't matter if it's been on the ground.
Yeah.
You know, you throw something out of it. Many times you're walking down the street and you see stuff flying out of carriages. Kids love to throw stuff out of carriages.
Oh, yeah.
So, I mean, since you carry tons of stuff in the carriage already, I guess you can throw this in there too.
Yeah.
And be confident that you can throw stuff in it and sanitize it on the run.
Yeah. I mean, I would definitely feel like if I was a parent, and to me, I'm not a germaphobe, but I would probably be a germaphobe for someone else, and especially my children, you know.
Oh, yes, that's interesting.
And then also I'm seeing some people say, you know, like makeup brushes or other cosmetic things. I mean, that stuff has been put right on your face with oils and all sorts of stuff, and it never gets cleaned. And this, you know, light cleaning seems kind of like the ultraviolet cleaning seems kind of like the only way to clean something like that. Yeah, I mean, I'm interested in it. I don't know if I would spend close to $100 in order to get it.
Yes, it's the old thing where we all grew up without sanitizing anything.
Yeah.
So,
a little soap, you know.
Yeah,
exactly. Lye on that and give it a good scrub.
Exactly. But if you're interested in that kind of thing, this is the biggest one of those devices that I've seen.
Yeah.
For Senate. Did you know who Howie Mandel is?
Yeah, I've heard of the name. It's not
He, a stand-up comic, yes. And he also hosts a couple game shows. And
Yes, he's bald. He did Beat the Banker and Deal or No Deal is what I'm thinking of.
Yes, Deal or No Deal.
Yes.
So at Toy Fair... I had done Deal or No Deal for Mad, and at Toy Fair, he was there plugging the Deal or No Deal home game. And so I said to one of the guys, oh, you know, can I say hello to him? I wrote the Mad satire. There he is. And she said, oh, sure. let me go ask him. So she came back. She said, he wants your autograph because he actually has that Mad magazine in his attaché case. She said, but don't touch him.
Yeah, I've heard of this.
Yes. He said,
very
he
big
said,
germaphobe.
Please fist bump or touch elbows because he doesn't want to touch anybody's hand.
You'll see when someone wins the $1 million on Deal or No Deal, they'll run over and hug him and he'll like, he's like, oh, okay.
Didn't sign up for this.
Yeah, so exactly. Funny. Yep. very funny. So yeah, he'd probably buy a whole bunch of these, have a backpack full of them wherever he goes.
Yes, that's very funny. That's very funny.
Interesting. That's three great gadgets that we will see.
I think I have one left over that I may start next week's show with.
Sounds good.
I have to look through my videos. But now, that means it's
ladies
time for the latest Chad's crappy.
There we go.
But you might want it at Chad's crappy corner. Get it.
Okay, so the results are in. You guys voted, and I went out and bought. Let me log in.
Well, wait a minute. Those guys were
our faithful patrons who support the show every single episode. Thank you guys so much. I'm trying to grab this straw poll. Here we are. And here were the options that the patrons could choose between. Stocking stuffers, gag gifts, sort of like white elephant gifts, or cooking gadgets. And the results are in. Stocking stuffers took it away with 46% of the vote. Just one vote under 100 votes. So I went out and searched for some stocking stuffers. And this one I found was also an as-seen-on-TV gadget.
Ooh.
So this would be for someone who is a little bit artistic or who likes to claim stuff as their own and wants other people to know about it. It is...
Here, engraving.
The engraving... Oh, I can't... There we go. Engrave It Pro. So this is a small handheld engraving tool. It comes with the Engrave It Pro and an extra little engraving bit. And then also it comes with some...
extra engraving bit is for capital letters.
There you go. Exactly. Right. It's for... You also have stencils. There you go. That's the word. English is my first native language.
That's good.
Yeah, I thought that was quite nice. If I could get in. Here we are. Get into the stencil. So I also brought over a few things to engrave. By the way, here are the stencils. You get first off letters. Which are nice to have, obviously. Capital
they
and lowercase
get lots
and numbers.
Of sizes or just one size?
Just one size, unfortunately. Okay. The other ones you have are a few love, wish, joy, peace, smile, and a few designs. And then they give you a flower design, which you could do basically a full-on flower, or you could just do one or a few of the flowers and some borders and things like that. So I have a few things to engrave. And I chose to go through all the materials. So I have a little piece of wood. This is a stir stick from Home Depot. I have a piece of plastic. This is actually the a paper airplane launcher.
Oh, the airplane thing. Yes.
Yeah, it's the airplane launcher. And then I have a piece of metal. So I have.
I wouldn't even bother engraving that because I don't think anybody's going to steal that.
I don't think anyone's going to need the. Yeah, going to take that away from me.
But paint a mouth on that, and you got a little person.
Exactly. Maybe that's
engrave
what we'll do. We'll engrave a mouth on that. So let's start off now. One thing that I wanted to test before we jumped into here is looking on the back. One of the things it claims is that the tip will not even puncture a balloon. So I brought myself a balloon here.
Oh, great.
So we can test it out. It's pretty simple. It has a single button on the top, takes two AA's to charge it or to plug it in. So balloon.
So Mythbusters is not on the air anymore. We've taken over.
I think it's going to pop it.
I think it is too.
It lasted for about half a second.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, he has more.
We have another. This one I'm not going to blow up so much, and this one's a fresh one. So, and I'm also going to try to kind of move it across because I'm wondering if, if you leave it there. So.
Yeah. Move it like you were writing Chad on the board.
Nope. It popped popped immediately, and I didn't blow that one up that much. Okay. No, well.
You know, you have an inner tube from a car tire.
Exactly.
That might
work. Okay. So that first claim. Right out. So,
someone in the chat room said, they meant it won't pop it if it's not running.
Right. Actually, probably that's what they mean. Well,
okay.
It wasn't running. Okay. Well, let's use the engraving tool first on wood. It must do well. On
it's
wood.
Got to do well. Really funny, you put it down and the wood goes pop and splatters.
I'm basically expecting that at this point. Okay, so let's start off with my name.
Okay. Oh, this is
wow! This sounds
this is
fantastic.
Too much like going to the dentist.
Yeah. Oh. Okay. Okay, so here we'll get a nice shot of this. Hopefully, if we can. See it. There's a C engraved in that wood. And
I see it. Okay.
There
I
it see is.
The
there
C.
Is
it's hard
C.
to see. It's hard
it's
to
hard
see the C, but I
it's
see
hard
the
to
C.
See. Okay, so C wood that worked. Okay, let's grab a grab this. Is there anything we could engrave on here? No. We're gonna have to freestyle
a mouth. Doc, I need more Novocaine, Doc. You're killing me.
It seems, pretty okay. It's not jumping around too much or anything. Okay, you kind of see that mouth on there, right?
Oh, yeah, that's not bad. That's not bad. I'm mainly interested to see what it's going to do on the metal.
Good. Okay.
That's pretty good.
Well, let's bring that over.
That's pretty good.
Now this one I should try to get my name on these scissors.
Yeah, because
nice.
That's going to be really the hardest thing.
Yeah. I'm trying to figure out maybe not a name. Maybe let's do a star here.
Because
I'm realizing the stencil, while it's great. If I go to C,
the stencil is awfully big.
A C I could put right here. And with the edge of this, I could put it right there. But the H, I know how to spell, would go right here. And a hard stencil kind of doesn't. Anyway, let's put a star on this.
Okay. Doc, that's the wrong tooth. It's the one next to it.
Okay, there's definitely metal filings coming up.
It also sounds like it's dying.
Yeah. Maybe the bat, I may be pushing it too hard. Pushing it to the limit. Okay.
Let me see.
It did it. That's a star.
Oh, you know, that's pretty nice.
It's not a bad star.
No.
Looks like I needed to send a little more
batteries to do it.
Yeah,
but.
Exactly. I maybe needed to spend a little bit more time on a few of the other points.
No, that's not bad.
But that's
was this just $5?
How much did I spend on this?
Oh, it's not in the five and under.
No, we're not in the five and under at the moment. We found it. Sorry, I'm clicking and trying to show off the star at the same time. I found it online for $9.20 four since.
Okay. Now, did it come with batteries?
No.
So you put in good batteries then, right?
Yeah, put in fresh batteries.
Okay. And like name brand batteries.
Yeah, Energizer.
Okay. Oh, okay. Okay. Well, then that then you got.
So here's how the batteries work. Turned it on while I was righty tighty, lefty loosey. Here we go. Just inside of here. So yeah, Energizer batteries.
Oh yeah, yeah, they're good batteries.
Yeah. I mean, if your point is to engrave something, then hey, you haven't accomplished that, and it worked even on this this hard steel.
Yeah, actually, several people in the chat room think it's pretty decent for the price.
You know what? It's not that bad. I was worried it was going to be. I mean, don't bring it near any balloons, and you'll be fine.
That's all right.
But they say there's a few different types of Wow, I just realized they suggest that you stencil glass on here.
Oh, I could see that. I could see that happening.
So they suggest jewelry.
I'm surprised they don't say wear goggles, though.
Yeah, exactly. In a respirator. Glass. This looks like some type of metal. It's hard to tell. Copper. Right. Or the edge of a bike.
Right.
And, of course, it does come with one extra bit once you use up one so much that it doesn't work anymore. But hey, you know, if you're a mechanic, there's many reasons why you'd want to engrave something with your name on it, or I don't know if this is really an artistic thing, more of a utility, I would feel like. But if you're at a job site and your tools are constantly getting nabbed and you want to write your name on them, I think it's not that bad.
There you go.
Yeah.
You
I wonder go. How long the bits last, too, someone's asking.
What? Could you not, now that I think about it, could you not use a Dremel tool?
Sure, you could. But you're not going to get one for under $10, you know.
No, absolutely not. So. No, I'm just thinking that I have a Dremel tool, and I never thought about using it as an engraving thing.
Yeah, I'm sure you could.
Well, we all know what we're getting for Christmas, things that are engraved.
Engraved things. I'm going to use this to stuff more stockings with engraved stuff.
Yeah, so, there you go. You can just mail people broken balloons and they'll understand that you try to engrave.
I tried.
Them.
I really tried. It said it wouldn't puncture a balloon, but nope. So this is Spark Innovations Engrave It Pro, as seen on TV, is how I found it. It's under $10 and it is prime shipping.
Oh, that's great.
Available. So, that's pretty fantastic. And that is my crappy corner. Look forward to some more gadgets that you can put into a stocking. So smaller gadgets. And I'll have all sorts of stuff all month long, except on the last day of this month, we're going to do the best and worst of Giz Wiz, and please email your best and worst gadgets that you think we've done over the last year to mail@gizwiz.tv.
Yes, we need a few suggestions, folks.
We do. With that, let's jump into Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Foghorn.
And our viewer video is from Drew Haynes. It's a short video, but it is a great gadget. It is a gadget that cost $1,000.
Whoa.
So let's see Drew's camera.
Hi, Dick and Chad. This is Drew in Maine, and here's something from my warehouse. This is the Sony Mavica Model
F1
floppy disk based camera. I bought this back in 1999 for about $1,000. I used to take this on vacation, take a suitcase full of blank floppies.
Whoa. That looks nice. That looks expensive. Wow, that was fast.
Each disk could only hold about 12 pictures. And each image was only about 0.75 megapixels. This camera was cutting edge for its time. It had a 14 power zoom. was optically image stabilized, had a pop-up flash, and lots of manual features. That's my gadget.
Thanks, guys. That is a nice gadget.
Yes, I looked up. I looked up. So it could also do video.
Oh.
It could do 1 minute.
Wow.
It could do 1 minute of video with sound. And
the sound whole time would be, oh, sorry, I'm playing the...
Yes, it used to just play the warehouse theme.
It would only play the warehouse theme. Just as it's saving that file as you're recording.
Yes, as he said, a dozen pictures. That's why they traveled with a suitcase full of 1.4 megabyte floppy disks. The neat thing about it was getting the video or your JPEGs onto a computer was easy. You just took the disc out of the camera, put the disc into your computer.
I'm trying to remember, did eBay exist back then? Because if it did, that would have been the perfect thing.
Oh, I think it's eBay. All over eBay.
Take, you take a product of an image, you have to get on your computer.
Oh, yes.
I mean, back then, digital photography was horrible.
Yeah, and I'll tell you a funny story about what came after this is Panasonic came out with one of these that used a super disc. Do you remember the super disc?
Yes, it was the thing that was going to replace CDs. It was indestructible. You couldn't slide the thing back and poke the disc with your finger.
And they were from iOmega, and they were 2.40 megabytes, almost twice.
Yes.
The 1.4.
So much. I remember my next door neighbor had one, and he had a SuperDisc player.
Yes, I did too.
Yes, and he loved that for music.
Oh, I thought it was so astounding that you could put so much
data
on a SuperDisc. There it is. There's the SuperDisc player with its own parallel port.
Yeah, of course. And it looks like a plug into the wall. It didn't have enough power.
Oh, yes, I think it also needed power. Yes, I think it also needed power. So anyway, Panasonic came out with their version of the Sony thing, except it used a super disc. And I believe the resolution was better. And, of course, you could save more pictures. So this is at a press conference, and I said to the people, Panasonic, afterwards, I said, you know, I'm doing Good Morning America on Friday. I could do this camera. And the guy said, well, there are two in the world because it's not out yet. He said, but we'll lend you this for the weekend if you can just make sure
it doesn't break.
And get it back on Monday. So, I did it and took it to UPS. Actually, my UPS driver, who comes by every day, I said, listen, can you just scan this in now? Because this is like critical that they know it's not. Anyway, so 3 days later, they call me up and they go, you sent us an empty box. And I said, what? They said, yeah, the box came, but there's no camera in it. And I said, that cannot be. I said, I personally handed it to the UPS driver. And I said, I know the guy for years. She said, all right, well, then someone stole it.
Stole it in transit.
Within Panasonic. So anyway, 3 days later, I was so upset. I called back and I said, did the camera show up? I'm so upset. I know that there are only two of them. And she said, you know, I reread the email from the mailroom and I was mistaken. The camera's here. Where's the disc? I said,
SuperDisc?
Yes, exactly. I said, the SuperDisc? I said, it's full of my pictures. She said, oh, well, we need that back.
You can go to the store and buy one.
I said, let me ask you something. Can I go to the store and buy a disc and send it back? She said, that would work.
That would be great.
That would be good. So I called the PR.
Thanks for the Good Morning America piece, but we need our $12 CD back.
Can you believe that? So I called the PR department and they wrote me that they sent me a joke. They sent me like 50 discs. They didn't send me a camera, but they said, "Dick, we're so embarrassed." They said, "You know, those people, the checklist just says camera and a disc." And
you got an engineer. Yeah, the engineer says, "Ah, this Boolean is false, and we need it to be true."
Yeah, exactly.
I'm sorry. Exactly. You got to send me that disc. That is that is very hilarious.
Funny, isn't it? I had 3 days of thinking, who would?
That's anyway. Very funny. That's very yeah. funny. With that, let's move on to the letter.
Wasn't the Christmas jingle.
What? Oh, wait. Yes, it was.
Right? That was the Christmas jingle?
That was.
I guess it was. Okay. Okay. because Dancing Santa, that was bad Santa.
Yeah, Santa. Calm down. It needs more jingles, he says.
No, needs more. Exactly. From Bo Van Dayhopper. Bo Van Dayhopper. Subject: Star Wars Science Force Trainer 2 brain sensing device.
Oh, man.
Now just $50. I spotted Star Wars Science, Star Wars Science Force Trainer 2 brain sensing hologram electronic game. Works with iPad, a selected iPad and Android tablets. Maybe something you and Chad should review in the show. Well, guess what? I did it from a toy fair, and this is what it looks like. And then we can check the current price, see okay. if it's still on sale.
To toy fair.
He guides you through the experience.
So this is
okay.
The idea is that
the brain.
That's it.
Creating the experience where Luke raises the X-wing out of the Dagobah swamp. So if you look here, there's a small swamp amount, and you'll see a slight amount of the X-Wing raising out. If you don't concentrate, it will stay as it currently is. But if you do concentrate,
oh, it's sinking.
The headset will pick up the brainwave activity that you're generating.
No, you
that
watch.
That brainwave activity watch. Will then send a signal via Bluetooth to the device that's powering this unit, projecting a hologram image of that X-Wing fighter that will slowly raise up and come out of the Dagobah swamp.
Oh, you're doing it!
Just like Luke did. It's a three-sided hologram, so it has both a front and a side view.
Now, is it possible I did that, or are we in auto program?
Yes, we are in auto program.
I hate it! that's okay.
Funny.
You know what? So what is this sell for, and when is it coming out?
It's coming
out. We didn't want no reporter screwing up our demo.
But the year before, Mattel had how much is it now?
It's $67.90.
Okay, so it must have been $50, I guess, on Black Friday.
Yeah.
But it came down a lot in price because the guy in that video says it'll be $129. But, you know, to tell you the truth, I think after a while, I think you're going to be very bored with this.
Yeah.
It is fun. The first time, Mattel had a big tube, and you had to raise little things at the bottom of the tube to the top. And it took me like about 90 seconds to sort of get the feeling of how to do it. And it's kind of fun. But then I thought, you know, after a while.
After a while, you're basically just doing this.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. I mean, after you bring every friend in and they can't do it, but you can.
Yeah, exactly.
Then you kind of run out of steam. But anyway, so it's $67, and if you're interested, it is the Star Wars Science Force Trainer 2, the better version of the one they had introduced the year before at Toy Fair.
Works with select iPad and Android tablets.
Tablets.
And that select is fit inside of the device.
Exactly. That is correct.
Interesting. Very cool to see that again. And I don't know if I remember that it was in demo mode the first time.
No, I don't either. Right.
I saw that. Very, very funny. Well, with that, we have a few things to remind you of. First, we want to thank our patrons, patreon.com/gizwiz. We mentioned this before. They get access to vote on the crappy corner and any other thing that we don't know what to decide. We throw the patrons way. We have our own Patreon over at patreon.com/gizwiz. Patreon is a platform for you to support independent content creators like ourselves. And we really, really, really appreciate our patrons. Thank you so, 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 so much. Don't forget to play What the Heck Is It over at gizwiz.biz. GizWiz has two websites, basically. Gizwiz.biz, which Dick runs, and gizwiz.tv, which basically only has the show. So gizwiz.biz has nice write-ups about all of the gadgets that we talk about on the show. And it also has What the Heck Is It? And we're trying to guess what the heck this gadget is.
And now there is the first unveiling of the cover.
Oh, my gosh.
So you're playing for the February 2017 issue of Mad. It's always the largest selling issue, which is the 20 dumbest things of the preceding year. And in that issue...
He looks a little sick, maybe. Bit sick.
Yeah.
I have a number page. One, Trump got elected.
Got elected, yeah.
It's pretty funny.
I wonder how long it's going to be before when he's in office they send the boys around to the office.
Hey, see, magazine. We see what's going on here, see, and we don't like it. Exactly. Got to pay that insurance money or something bad might happen.
Mm-hmm.
So get a guessing as to what this gadget is, and you are in the running for a Mad Magazine signed by Dick himself. This is the gadget. It is obviously a scuba diving bell for a Barbie doll. Obviously.
Not a bad guess.
It's because it's correct. I figured it out. This is the whole gadget, not just part of it. And there's 12 Mad Magazines for correct answers and 24 Double the Mad Magazines, and normally a few extra thrown in for funny, hilarious, clever answers that make us chuckle. So get a guessing over at gizwiz.biz. Over at gizwiz.tv, that's where you can watch the show live. We are live every Thursday, or try to be, unless there's a interruption in our schedule, from 4:30 Pacific is when we start, 7:30 Eastern time. And you can head on over there and join the chat room and watch live. If you don't catch it live, we got all the past episodes on the website. So please head on over there, click on an episode. If you click the title of the gadget, it takes you to gizwiz.biz. If you click the link, it takes you to where you can find it online. And you can also subscribe on iTunes or YouTube. Thanks so much for watching this episode of the Giz Wiz. We'll see you next week.
I'll be here.
Wait a second. We have to go out with our...
I am loaded up and I'm ready to go. We're gonna fly through the sky in the Christmas snow. Got lots of stops and it's gonna be tricky quick. Let me take a selfie.
Bye. Woo.